वेलकम टू एशियन स्कूल ऑफ साइंस ई लर्निंग प्लेटफॉर्म। आई एम संतोष कुमार, 18 ईयर्स ऑफ टीचिंग एक्सपीरियंस इन आईआईटी जेई। सो टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस 11 मैथमेटिक्स थियरी ऑफ इक्वेशंस। सो वी हैव डन वन लेक्चर बेस्ड ऑन दिस थियरी ऑफ इक्वेशंस। स्पेशली वी लर्न ओनली क्वाड्रेटिक इक्वेशन एंड इट्स एप्लीकेशन। इट्स एप्लीकेशन मीन्स एनी फोर्थ ऑर्डर इक्वेशन कैन बी कन्वर्टेड इंटू सेकंड ऑर्डर, or any third order equation can be converted into second order like that. So applications also we will learn in this chapter. So let us start. And moreover, from this chapter every year one JEE question, JEE based question, one question will be asked in every year JEE main examination. And this chapter is very very important for JEE advanced also, because based on this chapter, properties of quadratic equation and properties of curves of quadratic equation. So there are plenty of applications used in all advanced level problems. So let us start. So what is definition of quadratic equation? Already everybody knows, in 10th standard also you learned. So quadratic equation is in the form of ax square plus bx plus c. This is called standard form. Here a, b, c are constants. These are, they may be real numbers or they may be complex numbers also. So up to 10th standard you studied about only real numbers. So here in place of ABC you used to put 1, 2, minus 1 by 2, root 3 by 2 like that. But in higher level problems you will put complex numbers also. Last lecture I told what is mean by complex numbers. While starting complex number chapter, so I will give you explanation in detail. So here ABC are three constant, and especially you need to remember this A is called leading coefficient. For any polynomial of order n, the highest power n, x power n, that coefficient is called leading coefficient. So that should not be equal to 0. If it becomes 0, then it will become, it is not a quadratic equation, it becomes a linear equation. So it should not be linear, leading coefficient should not be equal to 0. And roots also you have done, so minus b plus r minus under root b square minus 4ac upon 2a, this is called discriminant. So it has exactly two roots. That may be equal, that may not be equal, that may be real, that may not be real, but every nth order equation should have n roots compulsory. So either may be real or it may be real up to 10th standard. So you studied if delta less than 0, there is no real root. No real root means it does not have root. This is not like that. So no real root means there will be the roots definitely, but they are not real. Okay. So if second order equation is given, there should be definitely two roots. Either they may be real or they may be non-real, but two roots should have. If you take third order equation, definitely it has three roots. Fourth order equation, four roots. Nth order equation, n roots. Okay. Now, if roots are given, in 10th standard also you studied, I think, formation of equation. If alpha, beta are the roots, then what will be the equation? X minus alpha into x minus beta is equal to 0, or x square minus sum of the roots into x plus product of the roots is equal to 0 when two roots are given for the quadratic equation. So means we will represent quadratic equation means any equation with f of x. Okay, right. Now here if alpha beta are the roots, in lower level you studied sum of the roots is given by alpha plus beta is equal to minus b by a, and product of the roots will be c by a, and difference of the roots here. So already in basic formulas means in theory of indices I gave a formula, and which is the relation between a plus b whole square minus a minus b whole square and a plus b whole square plus a minus b whole square. So from that you will get alpha minus beta whole square. See, you know alpha plus beta, you know alpha beta, and you know you want to find alpha minus beta. So a minus b whole square can be written as a plus b whole square minus 4ab. So a minus b whole square can be written as a plus b whole square minus 4ab. According to that formula, if you simplify and if you substitute these values, difference of the root, that is modulus of alpha minus beta, you will get under root of b square minus 4ac by modulus of a. And in higher levels you should remember square root of any number is always positive. Any means any positive number is always positive. Okay, so square root of 3 positive, square root of 4 positive, square root of 5 positive, square root of 10 positive, square root of 2 by 3 positive. Every square root is always positive, that you should remember. And relation between the coefficients and roots. So here we should learn little bit higher. So here you see, if any quadratic equations roots are in the ratio m is to n, then you need to take roots as m alpha and n alpha, like mk and nk. In lower levels also you have studied, if a is to b is equal to 2 is to 3, a can be taken as 2k, b can be taken as 3k, like that. If roots are in the ratio m is to n, then m alpha and n alpha you need to take as the roots. And if roots are in the ratio m is to n, there is a relation between coefficients and roots. This formula we will be derived in detail in later classes. So here you should remember, m plus n whole square into ac is equal to mn bc. Okay, right. So nature of the roots, in 10th standard you studied nature of the roots depends on discriminant. So here discriminant value is b square minus 4ac. So if discriminant is equal to 0, then both roots are equal. So in the formula, if you substitute in the roots formula, minus b plus r minus under root b square minus 4ac upon 2a. In that formula, if discriminant is 0, then roots become minus b upon 2a. Both roots are equal and root will be equal to minus b upon 2a. If roots are not equal, then we need to discuss in depth. So if roots are not equal means delta not equal to 0. So delta may be positive and delta may be negative. If delta is positive and both three numbers a, b, c are real numbers, we are discussing for only real numbers. If a, b, 3 are real numbers, a, b, c are real numbers, and we will see the cases. If delta is a perfect square, if delta is a perfect square, and here especially a, b, c should be rational numbers, a, b, c should be rational number, and d should be a perfect square, then we can say roots are rational. Roots are rational means root b square minus 4ac can be simplified as a small number that is non-third. Okay, so you will not get a third, you will get a rational number. Okay, right. If a, b, c are rational numbers and d is not a perfect square, if discriminant is not a perfect square, in 10th standard also you studied, so roots should be irrational. Roots should be irrational, so means roots are like thirds. So one root is, if it is in the form of p plus root q, another root should be definitely p minus root q. So these two are called conjugate thirds. Conjugate thirds, these roots exist in pairs only. Only p plus root q cannot be the root of a quadratic equation. If p plus root q is a root, then definitely p minus root q should be the root of the same equation. So these both roots exist in pair only, they will not exist in single. Okay, now here second case, here delta less than 0, discriminant less than 0, and both a, b, c numbers are real numbers, then roots are called imaginary numbers. So already I told, imaginary numbers are in the form of p plus iq. Already we studied in first lecture. So what is mean by I here? I is called iota, and iota value is given by square root of minus 1. Okay, so let us solve some examples. Here a, b, c are three real numbers such that a plus b plus c is equal to 0 and a not equals to c. Then roots of the equation, our equation is given, b plus c minus a into x square plus c plus a minus b into x plus a plus b minus c into c is equal to 0. So generally, to determine the nature of the roots, you need to find out discriminant. So for shortcuts, so especially in the competitive examinations, you need to find out shortcuts for each and every question. Most of the questions will be solved by short method. So if you try to find discriminant like a plus b whole square, means if you take a discriminant value b square minus 4ac, that is here b square means c plus a minus b whole square in minus 4 into these two terms, first and last term. So product of these two terms, will you will get 9 terms, here 6 terms, total 15 terms. If you simplify that 15 terms, it will be very difficult and time consuming. Okay, so for that I will give a small shortcut. So see, put x is equal to 1 in the equation, what you will get? F of 1. So whatever the equation is given, that I am taking as f of x, in place of x I am putting 1. So you will get, in place of x square you will get 1, in place of x also you will get 1. See the coefficients, minus a plus a cancel,
minus b plus c cancel, minus c plus c cancel, you will get a plus b plus c. But in the question, they have given 0 is equal to a plus b plus c, means f of 1 value is 0. And means in place of x, if you put 1, the equation is satisfied. So 1 is called root. 1 is called root. So any quadratic equation having a root which is real, then other root is also definitely real. So see here, 1 is the root of the quadratic equation. So alpha value we got 1. To find beta, what I am taking? Product of the roots, c by a. So this is the constant term, this is the x square coefficient. If you put alpha value 1 over here, 1 into beta become beta, so you will get second root. Okay, so second root also you get. So a, b, c are real numbers they have given. So real number by real number, you will get a rational number, means real root. Here also real root, and these may not be equal. And in the question also they have given a not equal to c. So here also a minus c, here also c minus a. Okay, so b here, a minus c, here c minus a. So means like b minus y, either b plus y. So like that. Okay. So here question, in case of a and c both are same. So here you will get b by b. So beta value you will get 1. So both are equal roots you will get. So here that's why they have given condition a not equals to c. So this will be looking like b plus x by b minus x, like that. Yeah, b plus some constant by b minus some constant. So finally you get the two roots. First root is 1 and another root is a plus b minus c upon b plus c minus a. Okay, so these two are real numbers. So conclusion is roots are real and distinct, they are not equal. So delta greater than 0. So answer will be a. So if you find delta, you will get greater than 0, but that is a lengthy process. I am not finding delta. Okay, second question. So this type of questions also you done in 10th standard. So the value of m for which the quadratic equation has equal roots. So when a quadratic equation has equal roots, so discriminant 0. So let us do. So see, discriminant I am taking. What is discriminant? B square minus 4ac. B square means this middle term coefficient square, that is 2 square. Minus square become plus, 2 square means 4, and 5 plus 2m whole square. Minus 4ac, 4 into a value 1 and c value, this entire thing. So I have written here is equal to 0. And simplify this. So here 4 and 4 taken common and took that side. So it becomes 0. So 5 plus 2m whole square become 25 plus 4m whole square plus 20m. Minus 4 is gone. So 3 into 7, 3 7s are 21. 3 into 10, that is 30m. If you simplify, you will get the quadratic equation. 4m square minus 10m plus 4. Again take 2 common. So 2m square minus 5m plus 10. Again means it is a quadratic equation. So the simple way to solve the quadratic equation, splitting middle term. So see here, 2 into 2, the product you will get 4. So factors of 4, if you add, you will get 5. So 4 ones are 4, 4 plus 1, 5. So you know, I think 10th standard splitting middle term. So if you factorize, so this entire equation having factors like this, 2m minus 1 into m minus 2. So m value will get 1 by 2 comma 2. So there are two values. So in the previous question, means in this question, see what they have given this question and m value they are asking. Actually we got m value 2 and 1 by 2. So but in the options there is no 1 by 2. So that's why you need to take 2. Okay. Right. Example 3. So let us start. Alpha, beta are the roots. This is a previous year JEE question, and this type of question they are asking frequently. So alpha, beta are the roots of ax square plus bx plus c is equal to 0. Then the value of beta upon a alpha plus b plus alpha upon a beta plus b. So whatever the function they are asking, whatever the value they are asking, you need to observe very keenly. So here a alpha plus b, see here ax square plus bx, if you take x common you will get ax plus b, means in place of x they are asking to put alpha, means already you know that alpha beta are the roots. So substitute in that question, see here alpha is a root, so substitute there, a alpha square plus b alpha plus c is equal to 0. So from first two terms take alpha common and take c to right side. So you will get alpha into a alpha plus b is equal to minus c. And take alpha that side. So this alpha you take this side, bring means this is in the product. If you bring this side, it becomes into denominator. So what you will get, a alpha plus b is equal to minus c by alpha. In the same way, beta is also a root. So you will get a beta plus b is equal to minus c by b. So now the question is b by a alpha plus b and alpha by a beta plus b. So beta as it is, what is a alpha plus b value? So minus c upon alpha. A beta plus b value minus c upon beta. So this alpha will go to numerator, this beta will go to numerator. So you will get alpha beta upon minus c, alpha beta upon minus c. Finally, you will get minus 2 alpha beta upon c. So minus 2 by c as it is, what is b alpha beta product of the roots of c by a? So c, c get cancelled, minus 2 by a will be the answer. Okay, next. Alpha, beta are the roots of this equation. This type of questions are also they are asking in JEE examination. So 4x square minus 6x plus 1 is equal to 0. Then they are asking to find the value of alpha square upon beta and beta square upon alpha. They are given the options. So let us start. Here we are going to use the formulas alpha plus beta, sum of the roots minus b by a and product of the roots c by a. So if you take here LCM, alpha cube plus beta cube you will get. So that formula is taken as alpha cube plus beta cube is alpha plus beta whole cube minus 3 alpha into alpha plus beta. Basic formulas we have learned in initial lectures. Okay, let us start. So alpha plus beta value minus b by a. So b value 6 and a value 4. So sorry, b value minus 6 and a value 4. So total it becomes 6 by 4, that is 3 by 2. Okay, so you can observe equation over here. See here. A value 4, b value minus 6 and c value 1. Okay, right. So minus 6 upon 4, that is minus of minus 6 become plus 6 upon 4, that is 3 by 2. Alpha beta value c by a, c value 1 and a value 4. Okay, now this formula alpha cube plus beta cube value. So I am finding alpha plus beta value, you know, 3 by 2. Its cube becomes 27 by 8 minus 3 into alpha beta value 1 by 4. Alpha plus beta value 3 by 2. So if you simplify, you will get 27 upon 8 minus 3 1s are 3 1s are 3. So 3 3s are 9 upon 8. Okay. So 27 upon 8 minus 9 upon 8. So 27 minus 9 upon 8, that is 18 upon 8. So it becomes 9 by 4. Okay. Right. So here the question, alpha square upon beta plus beta square upon alpha. So you will get LCM if you take alpha cube plus beta cube upon alpha beta. So you know the value of alpha cube plus beta cube, how much we got? 9 upon 4 whole upon alpha beta value also there, 1 upon 4. So simplify, you will get 9. Okay, right. Next question here also. See, if the ratio of the roots of the equation is lx square minus nx plus n, so don't get confused here, only n, both are n only, okay, is equal to p is to q, then they are asking to find the value of square root of p by q plus square root of q by p is. So they have given four options. Okay, now here what they have given is actually the hint. Why I am giving hint? So if you want to try the question, pause the video and check the hint, and based on this hint you try to solve the question. So that's why I am giving hint. Okay, now see here, if roots are given in the ratio p is to q, so alpha is taken as kp and beta is taken as kq, so that you will get the sum of the roots and product of the roots. See here. So alpha is to beta are in the ratio p is to q. So alpha can be taken as pk or p can be taken as alpha k. I am taking p can be taken as p is taken as alpha k. Q can be taken as beta k. So in both the ways you can take, there is no problem. Okay. So sum of the roots alpha plus beta value minus b by a, that is minus of minus n upon l, and alpha into beta c by a, c value is n and a value is l. So this is basic concept in 10th standard you studied about alpha plus beta and alpha into beta. Now see, p plus q value I am taking. Why I am taking p plus q value, let us see. So what is p value here? From p, alpha k, q value beta k. So alpha k plus beta k. If you take k common, alpha plus beta into k. So what is alpha plus beta value? You know, n by l into k. And the product of p पी क्यू एम टेकिंग, सो अल्फा के इंटू बीटा के, दैट इज अल्फा बीटा इंटू के स्क्वायर. सो द क्वेश्चन इज अंडर रूट ऑफ पी बाई क्यू प्लस अंडर रूट ऑफ क्यू बाई पी. इफ यू टेक एल सी एम, दिस रूट पी शुड बी मल्टीप्लाइड विद दिस रूट पी एंड दिस रूट क्यू शुड बी मल्टीप्लाइड विद दिस रूट क्यू. सो रूट पी इंटू रूट बी बिकम पी, रूट क्यू इंटू रूट क्यू बिकम क्यू. सो पी प्लस क्यू अपन रूट पी क्यू इज इक्वल टू, राइट, वॉट इज पी प्लस क्यू वैल्यू? पी प्लस क्यू वैल्यू वी हैव टेकन एज अल्फा प्लस बीटा इंटू के, एंड अंडर रूट ऑफ पी क्यू वैल्यू बीटा अल्फा बीटा इंटू के स्क्वायर. सो स्क्वायर रूट ऑफ के स्क्वायर बिकम के एंड दिस के विल गेट कैंसल. नाउ रिप्लेस अल्फा प्लस बीटा वैल्यू एंड अल्फा बीटा एस. सो वॉट इज अल्फा प्लस बीटा वैल्यू? एन अपॉन एल सी एन अपॉन एल बाय अंडर रूट ऑफ अल्फा बीटा वैल्यू एन अपॉन एल एन अपॉन एल. सो दिस इज एन अपॉन एल होल डिवाइडेड बाई स्क्वायर रूट ऑफ एन अपॉन एल, लाइक इट इज लुकिंग लाइक ए अपॉन रूट ए. सो यू विल गेट रूट ए. सो दैट इज रूट एन अपॉन एल. दिस इज द आंसर. नाउ वन मोर क्वेश्चन. सो हियर दिस क्वेश्चन इज ऑल्सो प्रीवियस जे डब्ल क्वेश्चन. सो दिस इज बेस्ड ऑन सिंपल बेसिक कॉन्सेप्ट बेसिक मैथमेटिक्स. ओके, सो वाई आई एम डिस्कसिंग दिस क्वेश्चन मीन्स एवरी ईयर इन जे डब्ल एडवांस दे आर फोकसिंग वन क्वेश्चन एस्पेशली ऑन बेसिक मैथमेटिक्स. सो इट मे बी क्वाड्रेटिक इक्वेशन, इट मे बी लॉगरिथम्स, इट मे बी सर्ड्स, और इट मे बी एनी जनरल नॉलेज क्वेश्चन लाइक प्रीवियसली दे आस्क क्वेश्चन बेस्ड ऑन एल सी एम एंड एच सी एफ. ओके, सो लाइक दैट क्वेश्चन दे विल आस्क, दे विल इन्वॉल्व मैथमेटिक बेसिक कॉन्सेप्ट स्पेशली. नाउ हियर एक्स स्क्वायर माइनस थ्री मॉड एक्स प्लस टू इज इक्वल जीरो. सो here they are asking number of real roots. Okay, number of real roots. So let us find number of real roots. Okay, right. So mod x will be here. So modulus means it is called absolute value of x. What is mean by absolute value? So either it inside the modulus, either it is positive or negative, we should consider only positive value. So mod x can be written as plus x if x is greater than 0, means inside there is a positive number, no need of keeping modulus sign. Inside if it is a negative number, so you need to take opposite sign. So if x is less than 0, you need to take minus x. Okay, so according to that, let us see x square minus 3 mod x plus 2 is equal to 0. So here modulus of x, so it may be positive or it may be negative. So according to this situation, if x is positive, for example x value greater than or equal to 0, let it be. So x square minus 3x plus 2 is equal to 0. Okay, so because mod x can be replaced with x. If x less than 0, x can be replaced with minus x. So you will get two equations. Okay, x square minus 3x plus 2, here it becomes x square plus 3x plus 2, and you easily solve this equation. So it becomes x minus 2 into x minus 1, here also x plus 1 into x plus 2, here you will get the roots 1 and 2, here minus 1 and minus 2. See, after getting these roots we need to check. So this case when we have taken, when x value positive, see here positive, positive means you replaced mod x with plus x. So what are the roots? X is equal to 1 and 2. These two are also positive. Means this condition is satisfied over here. For example, if you get 1 and minus 2, so minus 2 should be neglected. Here also, x we have taken as negative. See, minus x when we should replace when x is negative. So here both roots are negative. Okay, so these two values are also accepted. So if for example here you get plus 1, so this should be neglected. Okay, right. So total how many roots we got? 1, 2 and minus 1, minus 2. So total 4 real roots. Okay. Now let us see one more question. This is also previous JEE question. So most competitive examinations also they are asking this type of questions. So see here. It is a quadratic equation, but it is not looking like a quadratic equation. This is application of quadratic equations. So here 7 plus root 3, 4 root 3 whole power mod x minus 8, 7 minus 4 root 3 whole power mod x minus 8 is equal to 14. Then the number of real roots, how many real roots it has. Okay, let us check. Same here, mod x also can be taken as plus x and minus x according to the value of x. Now see here two sets they have given, 7 plus 4 root 3 and 7 minus 4 root 3. So if you multiply these two, what you will get? 49 minus 48, that is 1. If two numbers product is 1, means 1 is the reciprocal of other. See, so 7 minus 4 root 3 can be written as 1 upon 7 plus 4 root 3. Now see, this 7 plus 4 root 3 whole power mod x minus 8 I am taking as y. Okay, so what about 7 minus 4 root 3? See here, 7 minus 4 root 3 can be written as 1 upon 7 plus 4 root 3. So this also can be written as 1 upon 7 plus 4 root 3, power also applied over here. So this will be 1 upon y. So if this entire term is taken as y and this entire term minus term will be 1 by y. Now replace in the question. So this is the question. So this entire value we have taken y, and this entire value becomes 1 upon y. So y plus 1 upon y is equal to 14 you will get. Okay. Now if you take LCM, y square plus 1 is equal to 14y. Bring 14y this side. So y square minus 14y plus 1 is equal to 0. See here. Y is equal to plus or minus, if you solve this quadratic equation according to the quadratic formula, y is equal to plus or minus 196 minus 4 under root upon 2. So if you simplify, you will get plus 7 plus or minus 4 root 3. So what is y value? Actually we have taken 7 plus 4 root 3 upon power mod x minus 8. So here you will get 7 plus 4 root 3 and as well as 7 minus 4 root 3. So let us consider both the cases. If we will take 7 plus 4 root 3, see here, y value 7 plus 4 root 3 power mod x minus 8. So this y value, if I consider 7 plus 4 root 3, here both side bases are equal. So exponents or powers should be compared. So mod x minus 8 is equal to, here the power will be 1. So mod x minus 8 is equal to 1. So bring this minus 8 this side. So mod x is equal to 9. If you remove modulus, so you will get plus or minus n 9. So it means inside the modulus, if you keep 9, you will get answer 9. Inside the modulus, if you keep minus 9 also, you will get the value 9. So here x value, it may be plus 9 or minus 9 next. So same y value, if I take 7 minus 4 root 3, see here, this is the y value. If I take 7 minus 4 root 3, so it becomes 1 upon 7 plus 4 root 3. This is equal to, so this can be written as 7 plus 4 root 3 whole inverse. Okay, now bases are equal, so powers should be equated. Mod x minus 8 is equal to minus 1. So take this minus 8 right side. So mod x is equal to, you will get 7. So remove modulus. Whenever you remove modulus, so another side you will get plus or minus. X value will be plus or minus 7. Okay, so totally how many values you will get? So mod x means x value plus 9 minus 9 and x value plus 7 minus 7. Totally 4 real values you got. So answer is number of real roots will be 4. Let us see one more question. The number of solutions of this equation 9x square minus 18 mod x plus 5 is equal to 0. Here also same. So mod x can be taken as plus or minus x. So two quadratic equations you will get. So see here, plus 18x and minus 18x. So if you solve these two equations, okay, so if you solve these two equations, the roots you will get 1 by 3, 5 by 3, and minus 1 by 3, minus 5 by 3. Here, so from this side, you got 1 by 3 and minus 5 by 3. So here, this equation considered when x positive. So this is correct only, both are positive. This equation, here mod x value we have taken minus x, means x is negative. So when x is negative, so here the roots are also negative. So this is also correct. So total values will be 4. And one more condition they have given, and these roots should be belongs to domain of this logarithm function. What is mean by domain? Means in place of x, whatever the values we can able to keep, so those values are called domain. Okay, so for example, in place of x, if I want to put minus 1, minus 2, or 0, or minus 1, whatever it may be. So this value, means this logarithm function should be defined. So in basic lecture logarithms, I told that, so logarithm of here, whatever the number you are keeping, that should be always positive.
it should not be 0, means x plus 1 into x plus 2 should not be 0 and should not be negative. This should be positive. So to find the domain, means whenever this function is defined, means this entire function should be positive. See here, x plus 1 into x plus 2 greater than 0. So you need to find out the values of x for which this entire equation greater than 0. For that, there is a wavy curve method that we will discuss in later classes. See here, I will give a simple logic. Here the roots are minus 1 and minus 2. Okay, so on number line, if you place minus 1 minus 2, here from right side, you should go left side by keeping the positive sign. So after minus 1, so entire numbers you keep it as positive, and between minus 1 and minus 2 you keep negative sign, and less than minus 2 you can keep positive sign, like that. So plus minus plus, according to that, so here the domain easily you can find out. So the domain will be x belongs to minus infinity to minus 2. If you don't understand, so check any reference books, wavy curve method to solve linear inequalities, easily you can understand. So minus infinity to minus 2 and minus 1 to infinity. So these are the values of x for which this function is defined. Now we need to compare whatever the values lies in this domain, those values only they are asking. See, 1 by 3 means 0.3. 0.3 is lies in this. So after minus 1 only we will get. So minus 1, see, 5 by 3. 5 by 3 means near about 1 point something. So that is also lies in this. Here, minus 0.3, near about minus 0.3, which is it lies in this? So definitely lies. After minus 1 only you will get. Here, minus 5 upon 3 means minus 1 point something. So it is lies between minus 1 and minus 2. But here that values are not included in this domain. So we can take the values 1 by 3, 5 by 3 and minus 1 by 3 only. This is not included in the domain of this logarithm function. So required values will be only 3. So both satisfies from 1 and 2, both equations. So the values satisfied both equation will be 1 by 3, 5 by 3 and minus 1 by 3. So total number of values of x will be 3. So thank you, students. If you like this video, please share to your friends and subscribe to our channel. Thank you very much. Have a nice day.